I throw lecture on the subject compiler design. Subject code PCC CS501. This is for computer science and engineering students. I am Konkan Jana, assistant professor of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management, GIS Group. This is Module 3 of the subject Compiler Design, having the subject code PCC CS501. The lecture based on the syllabus of BTech Computer Science and Engineering of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad University of Technology, West Bengal, formerly known as West Bengal University of Technology. This syllabus is applicable from the academic session 2018-2019. In Module 3 of Compiler Design, student of Computer Science and Engineering of fifth semester will know about syntax analysis. Module 3 has 9 lectures in total. Contents of Module 3 lecture is the role of a parser, context-free grammars, writing a grammar, top-down parsing, non-recursive predictive parsing, bottom-up handles, vowel prefixes, operator precedence parsing, LR parser, SLR, LALR, parser generator, YACC, error recovery strategies for different parsing techniques. So, we will start lecture 3 of module 3 in this session. I am using digital whiteboard for better dictation. Important points and some reference will be written in this board. So, now in this lecture, we need to construct parse tree. The construction of a parse tree can be made precise by taking a derivational view. Construction of parse. In which production are treated as rewriting rules. Production are treated as rewriting rules beginning with the start symbol. Each rewriting step replaces a non-terminal by the body of one its production. So, what we have learned? Production as rewriting rules. Okay. And rewriting step replaces a non-terminal, okay, by body of one of its products. Okay, so this derivational view correspond to the top down construction of a parser. Of a parse tree. But precision afforded by derivation will be specially helpful when bottom up parsing is discussed. Bottom up parsing. As we shall see, bottom up parsing is related to a class of derivation known as rightmost derivation. Derivation. In which the rightmost non-terminal is written at each step. Now, for example, consider the following grammar with a single non-terminal E. Which adds a production E to E minus 1. To the grammar. And so we will get the production of it as. So, what was the derivation? This is my derivation for the E. And the production of E to minus E signifies that if E denotes an expression, then minus E must also denote an expression. If E denote an expression, then minus E also denote an expression. Okay. The replacement of a single E by minus E will be described by writing this. Okay. Which is read as E derives minus E. E derives minus E. So the production E to E can be applied to replace any instance of E in any string of grammar symbol by E. For example, you can replace it like that way. E that will be replaced by that symbol. Okay. Or also you can write it as like that. this E will be replaced as E star E dash. Okay. Now we can take a single E and repeatedly apply production in order to get a sequence of replacement. For example, which type of replacement? For example, E 2 implies 2 minus E. Okay, that will be implies as like that minus E. Okay, so in that way we can replace all these things. So here we will generate an ID. We call such a sequence of replacement a derivation of ID from E. Derivation of ID from where? From E. Okay. And this derivation provides a proof that the string ID is one particular instance of an expression. For a general definition of derivation, consider a non-terminal A. A non-terminal A in the middle of a sequence of what I am telling? A. In the middle of a sequence of grammar symbols as in alpha a beta. Okay, where alpha and beta are arbitrary string of grammar symbol. String of grammar symbol. Now suppose A implies the symbol gamma is a production. A implies the grammar for the productions of the symbol gamma. Then we write alpha a and b that will be implies to alpha gamma and beta. As because this is a productions of this symbol of this grammar. Okay. Here this symbol means derives in one step. This is the symbol we have used that will be derivations on in one step. When a sequence of derivation step alpha 1 to alpha 2 to alpha up to alpha n rewrite alpha 1 to alpha n, we say alpha 1 derives alpha n. But I like to say you, suppose this is the alpha 1 and this implies to alpha 2 and consecutively that will be imply up to
alpha n, okay, up to alpha n. So directly we can say alpha 1 is derived to alpha n. Often in some cases we say derives in zero or more steps, but the value will be in derivation in that way. For this purpose we can use the symbol, this symbol we can use it directly, that will be generated for any type of string. Thus we can say alpha derived one by one for the string of alpha, okay, and in that way you will get it. Okay, if we use this symbol, that means alpha is derived one by one, step by step, sequentially for the alpha n. Okay. So we have learned about that. Now we will know about the parse trees and its derivation. A parse tree is a graphical representation of derivation that filters out the order in which production are applied to replace non-terminal. This is the parse tree of the derivation. This. This is the parse tree of the derivation. This. Okay. Each interior node of a parse tree represents the application of production. Interior node. These are the interior node of the production. Okay, what I have told you. Production. Okay. It may be labeled as A, or we can use E also. In the head of the production, the children of the name of the node are labeled from left to right by the symbol in the body of the production, by which this node A was replaced during the derivation. For example, we can see the parse tree for this minus d plus id we have generated in that way, okay, using the infix expression. Using the infix notation. Okay. So, and this is derived as this way. That one, this, and after that we get this parse tree. What is happening there? The leaves of a parse tree are labeled by non-terminal or terminal. Okay, non-terminal or terminals. Here this is. Okay. already have some expression. These all are the leaf nodes. These all are the leaf node. And this is read from left to right, from left to this section and right this section will be read again to this section, will be enter left, left, next right and right in that way. Actually, this is called yield or frontier of the tree. This is called yield or frontier of the tree. Yield or frontier of the tree. So, to see the relationship between derivation and passage, consider any type of derivation where which type of derivation I can give an example. Already I have told you alpha 1 to alpha 2 and up to alpha n and up to alpha n, where alpha 1 is a single non-terminal edge. Single non-terminal edge. This is non-terminal edge. Okay. For each sentential form alpha I in the derivation, we can construct a parse tree whose wild is alpha I. Okay. Whose wild is alpha. Okay, this is the wild of alpha I. Okay, so this process is an induction on I. What is the algorithm of it? Basis of it is the tree for alpha 1. The tree for alpha 1 equals to A. And this is a single node that will be labeled as A. And in that way, I will get this tree. This is the first tree. Okay, I have get it. In that way, after production and construction, and in the induction purpose, suppose we already have constructed a parse tree with the yield alpha I minus 1 equals to x 1 and x 2 this up to x k to x k. Okay, so note that according to our notational convention, each grammar symbol x I is either a non-terminal or a terminal. It may be non-terminal or it may be a terminal. Okay. Suppose alpha is alpha I is derived from alpha I minus 1. Alpha I derived from where? From alpha I minus 1. So, and by replacing xj value, I have replaced that one by the value of xj. So, the a non-terminal by that we will get beta equals to y1 and y2, and that will be continue up to y n m, for example. Okay, so that is the ith step of derivation. That is the ith step of derivation. And what I have get for this production, I have get xj to beta, and this is applied to, and this is applied for this alpha I minus 1, and that help us to get alpha equals to x1, x2, xj minus 1, and to beta xj plus xk, that. Okay, so we have get finally alpha I equals to x1, x2 up to xj minus 1, and again we have made another production for it, and that is beta xj plus 1 and up to xk, up to xk. So this model, this step of derivation, find the jth leaf node from the left in the current part step. This leaf is labeled at xj. So give this leaf m children. How many children are there? There must be m children. Okay. Label it y1, y2 up to ym from the left. As a special case, if m equals to 0, then beta suppose equals to epsilon. Okay. And we give the jth leaf one child labeled as epsilon, the final step. Clear? Okay. Next, we'll know about context-free grammar versus regular expression. Grammars are a more powerful notation than grammar regular expression. Every construct that can be described by a regular expression can be described by a grammar, but not vice versa. Alternatively, every regular language is a context-free language, but not vice versa. So, for example, the regular expression A or B star A B B and the grammar of it corresponding to that, this is the corresponding to that grammar. The same language, the set of string of A's of the set of string of A's of A and the set of string of B. The set of string of B ending in A, B, B. Okay, A, B, B. We can construct mechanically a grammar to recognize the same language as a non-deterministic finite automata. As a non-deterministic finite automata, that is NFA. This grammar construct from the NFA using the construction rules. What are those construction rules? For each state I, for each state I, of the NFA, create a non-terminal AI. Create a non-terminal AI. If second, this is the first one. Secondly, if state I has a transition to state J, okay, this is a state I, it have a transition to the state J. Transition to the state J on input A. So added the production of what? Production of A I to A J. A I to A J. Okay. And the third step, what we will get? If I is an accepting state, that is the accepting state, accepting state, what I like to tell you, this is the I is then accepting state. Accepting state. Okay. Then we will add what? We will add, so AI with the epsilon. Let AI with the epsilon. Clear? Next, if I is the start state, make AI be the start symbol of the grammar. So, if I is the start state, okay, then AI will be the start symbol of the grammar, start symbol of the grammar. Okay. On the other hand, the language L equals to, or you can say A to the power N, B to the power N, such that N greater than equals to 1 with an equal number of A's and B's is a prototypical example of a language.
that can be described by a grammar but not by a regular expression. To see why, suppose L were the language defined by the some regular expression, defined by some regular expression. Okay. L. We could construct a DFA D. Okay. We construct the DFA D with a finite number of state. Suppose this is K. Okay. Since D has only K, that is K, for an input beginning with more than K is, D must enter some state twice. Any SI. Suppose this is SI. Okay. So what we'll get from this diagram, we can see that we'll get this one. Suppose that the path from SI back to itself is labeled as a sequence of AJ minus 1. Since AI, BI is in the language. Okay. AI and BI is in the language. AI and BI is in the language. So there must be a path level BI, okay, BI, and from SI to an accepting state F. Okay. So we have get it in that way. Okay. So we have completed this lecture. Thank you.